Whatever your goal is, when you look at 2019 and you set a physical goal with your health and body, whether you set a goal with your relationships, and how you interact with those, whether you set a goal with your personal growth, or money-wise, right? Whatever the goal is, you need to set short bursts of attaining those, and you need to figure out like 90-day short burst, and then you need to figure out what you have to become to walk into that goal, right? Who's the you that deserves that?
What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Sales Wolves Podcast. I'm your host, Tyler Harris.
Joseph Caldwell.
And we are the Sales Wolves. Ow! Yes, that's right. This is episode 99, almost at the 100 mark. Episode 99, Sales Wolves Podcast. This is going to be a short one, but I think it'll be super relevant. Based on the fact that it is the first of the year and everybody's setting their New Year's resolutions and setting goals and things. Do you?
Yeah.
Resolutions? Like, what's the difference between a resolution and a goal?
I don't know. We should look that up.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it's a waste of time to wait until the new year to become what you need to become to walk into your goals, which...
2019 doesn't start January 1.
No.
No. It starts the whole fourth quarter, I believe.
It started somewhere back in the last 15 years.
The days of yore.
Yeah. I mean, you were becoming what you're going to be in 2019 your whole life.
Yeah. And we've put out some content here recently as we ended 2018 about the fact that, like, whether you were way ahead of your goal or whether you were just so far off that it wasn't even possible, how you ended 2018 will determine the momentum and
the momentum
trajectory going. That you have going into 2019. But now we're here. It's 2019. So now what do we do? So, you know, whether you believe in resolutions or not, we all believe in setting goals and the importance of that. But Joseph has an interesting take on goal setting and more on the fact of becoming the person who it's going to take to reach those goals.
Right. So whatever your goal is, when you look at 2019 and you set a physical goal with your health and body, whether you set a goal with your relationships, and how you interact with those, whether you set a goal with your personal growth, or money-wise, right? Whatever the goal is, you need to set short bursts of attaining those, and you need to figure out like 90-day short burst, and then you need to figure out what you have to become to walk into that goal, right? Who's the you that deserves that?
Yeah.
And that will show up at that future point having accomplished the goal. Because it's never about the goal, it's about who you become in the process.
Yep.
And if you start concentrating on the who you become in the process, the goal is a byproduct. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it makes sense. It's interesting, Amanda Maccabee, who we work with here at our home office, she has this process of writing a letter kind of detailing out all the things that will have happened in past tense. So I'm so grateful for this happening, this happening, this happening. So if you think about that and you take that and you just start thinking about writing out, you know, details about who that person is.
Yeah.
So man, like I'm so grateful for these things and that I've become this and the way I handle situations this way and the way I do this, the way I look, the way I feel, and start really visualizing that process.
So for example, let's take something that you did. Let's take you stopped drinking.
Yeah.
A year ago, year and a month almost.
Yeah.
And so about 13 months. That was a goal of Tyler's to stop drinking. So when you set that goal and you put the drink down, And 90 days out from there, the letter would have looked something like this. It's now April 1, mm-hmm. and I am so thankful I haven't had a drink over the last 3 months.
Yep.
Like, we're not against drinking, by the way,
yeah.
but that was something that was Tyler's goal, right, for him. And so the letter would look, I'm so grateful I stopped drinking over the last 3 months. This has impacted my life in these areas. This is the person that I've become in that process mm-hmm. of winning in this area of my life where I really wanted to win.
Yeah.
This is what my relationships look like now. This is what my, and see, he's writing that out as the person looking back over those, mm-hmm. having never started that process yet,
yeah.
having never walked through those 3 months. So it is a super powerful thing. The subconscious does not know the difference between a truth and a lie. You literally can convince your subconscious the sky is red.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't know you're not, it doesn't know.
Yeah.
And so when you detail those things out about what this feels like and what it looked like over the last 3 months, like you're literally journaling that whole last 3 month process and the things you overcame mm-hmm. in the process. You know, it was really hard for me that night that I went out downtown with all my friends. It was really hard, and they asked me a lot of questions, and it put me on the spot. But answering those questions and talking about those things to them, and you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, you're detailing those out before you ever hit that.
Mm-hmm.
It's super powerful. It is super powerful.
And I think something that's extremely important in this process is when you do have a monetary goal. Because there's so many people, you know, we're in the insurance business, we have insurance agents throughout the country, and there are agents that we have that we've made this comment about them. I don't know if Sally would know what to do with an extra $100,000.
Yeah.
I don't know if she even wants that, desires that, or if she had it, if she would know how to handle it.
Right.
So when you think of monetary goals and going through this process of saying, man, I'm so grateful that I've made X. Because of making X, I've been able to go on a take my family on vacation to this location for this many days and had this experience with my daughter, and I was able to pay off this debt that I've had. I was able to pay down this on my house. I was able to buy, you know, this car for my wife or my husband, and to actually start thinking about what you would do with that money.
Right.
Because unless you start thinking about what you're gonna do with the money that you earn, setting monetary goals is pointless.
Right.
Because so what's a number without what's attached to that number?
And attaching it to feelings
yeah.
is powerful. Mm-hmm. Attaching it to emotions. So you may be sitting here January, you'll be watching this January 2nd.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And you go, okay, so January, February 2nd, March 2nd, April 2nd. All right, and you set a goal, I'm gonna make $10,000 over the next 3 months. I'm gonna make $20,000 over the next 3 months. I'm gonna make $50,000 over the next 3 months. You set that in your goal. By April 2nd, I'll make this. And then you journal out, I want you to see what this looks like. You journal out what it felt like to make that, okay? It was unbelievably awesome to sit in that shoe store with my son and buy him the shoes that were more expensive.
Mm-hmm.
The light in his eyes, the smile on his face,
mm-hmm.
it couldn't be replaced. I'm so thankful that I did this over the last 3 months. I'm so thankful that I did X, 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 and X, right? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And the feeling it gave, it made me feel like the man. It made me feel like the woman. It made me feel, this is what it felt like to give my wife a surprise gift of a watch of mm-hmm. this and blah, 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 blah.
Yep.
And I bought it from Tiffany. She's wanted that for years, and I finally gave it to her, and this is what it felt like to give it to her.
Mm-hmm.
And this is how awesome the sex was after I gave it to her. I mean, you want to tie it to those
yeah.
base human emotions and needs, and it's the most powerful drivers.
I remember that story Sean Whalen talked about. He said he saw this guy posted, this year he's gonna get a Lamborghini.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, cool. He commented and he was like, cool, how are you gonna get it? You know, like, what's your plan? Like, how are you gonna get it? And he said, the guy said, I'm gonna hustle like I've never hustled before.
Right.
And he like responded to the comments, said something to the effect of like, that's cool, like, but like, how specifically, like what's like I get it, like you're hustling, like, but what's your specific plan? He said the guy's response was, why do you have to be such a dick? Because he had no plan. But like, if you think about that, like that's a great, like the, like, call it materialistic, whatever. If you want to get a Lamborghini next year, break it down. Okay, I need $200,000. So here's how much I have to make per month in order to get that
extra
at the end of this year.
Right.
And here's the action items. Like, here's the things that I have to do on a daily basis in order to generate the revenue to meet that goal to be able to then purchase that vehicle. And you can map it out. Like, whatever it is, you can map it out.
So that we're talking about goals now, right? So you if that's your goal, you map out specifically, like Tyler's saying, on a monthly, weekly, daily, hourly, every 15-minute basis, what you have to do. That's a goal section where you just factually, this is what's going to have to happen for that goal to take place. And then separately, you journal out what it felt like to do that. And not just what it felt like to then sit in the car, drive the car, take your family for a ride in the car. You detail out what it felt like to get up earlier. Hey, that first month in January, man, when I was getting up at 4 o'clock instead of 5, it sucked, man. It felt like my soul was being ripped from my body. But God, I'm so glad I did it. I'm so glad. Looking back now, it's the greatest thing I ever did. See, you're journaling as if it already happened, with the gratitude, with the thankfulness, with all of the emotions that are tied to you winning in that area, right?
And to tie this back into the theme of this episode, like, who is the version of you that owns a Lamborghini?
Right.
Like, who is that person? Because that's a very different person than the person that drives a Honda Civic. Mm-hmm. Like, those are two different people.
Two different.
And society would love to tell you about, oh, well, that person's this, this, and that. But like, for you, like, who is that person to you? Like, Andy Frisella talks about this a lot, and the feeling that he has when he pulls up to a gas station and the kids are all crowded around, they're taking pictures, and he's able to sit there and tell them, like, well, how in the world did you get this car? Like, by working hard over a long period of time. And the example he's able to set for all the people that admire the things that he has. But who is that person that's sitting in the driver's seat of whatever that specific thing that you want? Like, who is that person? And because until you become that person, you'll never have it. And
right.
I think that's it's a different mindset in looking at your goals to first look at the person you have to become and then figure out the things that you have to do to become that person.
Right.
Because the things that you have to do to become that person may be different than the things that you have to do to achieve that goal. Because it's kind of like they run in parallel, but they're two separate focuses. So, you know, a goal of selling 1,000 policies this year, which will generate this much income, there are steps and activities and things that you have to do on a daily basis that play out over months and quarters and over the year to get to that goal. But the person that sells 1,000 policies is a completely different person, and the steps that you have to take along the way to become that person are working in parallel with those action items. But it's a whole separate thing. It's a whole separate game that you're playing when you're trying to become a different person. And especially something I've seen happen throughout the last 4 years working with Joseph, as he has leveled up and as our organization has leveled up, he's had to become different people to take on different challenges and take on different situations that he knew he was gonna have to face. Mm-hmm. And so he had to go through things himself and put himself through intense discomfort and take himself out of his ordinary element and put himself in situations that he's never been in order to become that person. But that was completely separate from the goals that he had on a daily basis of running a business and pushing an organization to new heights. I think it's an interesting concept that most people just don't talk about.
They don't talk about it. And most people don't even realize it. Everything, they leave their goals and who they're becoming in such a gray area. They don't they don't pull it down and make it black and white and tangible. And it's just, you're doing yourself and even the making of the goal a disservice.
Yeah. So I think to close out this podcast, I'd love to mention, I don't know if it was like a meme or like if this was a quote that someone actually, you know, could actually coin as though they actually said it, but this idea of, man, you've changed. Man, you've changed. And the response was, did you think I worked that hard to stay the same? Like, did you think that I put in all this effort throughout this year to be the same person at the end of the year? Like, of course I've changed.
Of course.
Like, congratulations. Like, thank you. Like, yes, you're exactly right. I have changed.
You just want to look at that person and be like, and you didn't.
Yeah, you're right. I have changed, and you're the exact same.
You're the exact same. At least you're consistent. Yeah. I mean, that's what you want to do.
Consistently not impressive.
No.
but that's it. So, guys,
I hope this helps because 2019 is your year. It's your year if you get serious about this. It's your year. And you know what 2019 will do? It'll change your 2020, 2021, 2020 through forever.
I can't wait till 2020 comes and we can start talking about vision and clarity and
right.
And how you see the future. It's just going to be so much easier to create content.
Right.
But guys, with that, this
2020, is... 2020, baby. I see 2020.
This is episode 99 of the Sales Wolves podcast. As always, I'm your host, Tyler Harris.
And Joseph Caldwell.
We are the Sales Wolves.